exclusive interview with a woman whose confrontation with a black teenager in a New York hotel was caught on camera over the holidays. Cell phone video shows Mia Ponsetto accusing 14-year-old Keon Harold Jr. of stealing her iPhone last month. Ponsetto was arraigned over the weekend and freed on supervised release. She is charged with attempted robbery, attempted grand larceny, endangering the welfare of a child, and attempted assault. Well, we spoke with Ponsetto and her attorney, that's Sharon Gatan, just hours before her arrest last week. This morning, we begin where we left off on Friday. You seem to have attacked this teenager about the phone, and then it turned out he didn't even have your phone.
Okay, so
that's the thing.
Do you want to get to that part?
You're saying, look,
because
I'm 22 years old. You're 22
phone.
Years old, but you are old enough to know better.
Oh, the hotel
did have my... So I will say, you're
my...
22.
All right,
I get it.
Enough. The hotel did have my phone. The hotel did end up having my phone. I did get my belongings returned to me. So maybe it wasn't him, but at the same time, how is it so that as soon as I get asked to leave the premises, after I had accused this person of stealing my phone, how is it that all of a sudden they just miraculously have my phone when I come back? And it didn't seem as if my accusations really bothered the son and the father, because they were just enjoying a nice meal right after this whole encounter. But all I'm saying,
I don't know if you, Mia,
is I want
I don't
this
know
to be over,
what,
and I'm sorry.
Whether they were
so
bothered
I would love to make this short and sweet, Gail.
Mia, I want to go back to that day. Take us back to that day. We've all seen the video.
Okay, so. I arrived back to the hotel after grabbing some Starbucks. I had noticed my phone had been missing, so I just approached the hotel manager, asked him if he could kindly just check the footage. In my opinion, I was like, okay, any person walking down could possibly be the person that might have had my phone. I wasn't racial profiling whatsoever. I'm Puerto Rican. I'm like a woman of color. I'm Italian, Greek, Puerto Rican.
You keep saying you're Puerto Rican. Does that mean that you can't be racist because you're saying you're a woman of color? Is that what you mean?
Exactly.
Well, I would disagree with that. People of color can be racist too. Do you believe that you should pay a price for this?
I don't feel that my accusation is a crime.
But it's more than the accusation. It's the way that you tackled him, it seems, on the videotape. What would you do differently? You said that you look at that tape and that's not who you are.
I think I could have just asked the hotel manager. So yes, I could have stepped aside, or the father and I. We immediately could have started just speaking at a lower tone, and probably that would have handled the whole situation a lot better.
With all due respect, when Mr. Harold was talking to you, it seemed to me that he was responding to you because you had accused his son.
I'm saying that both of us. I said it, both of us.
You see two black people?
No, I'm not letting him walk away with my phone!
Bottom line is, this issue is much bigger than I think Mia is appreciating, and she sees it as a very simple thing.
Attorney Sharon Gatan sat with Ponsetto through the entire interview and wanted her client to feel empowered to tell her own story. But Gatan also felt it important to provide context on Ponsetto's state of mind at the time of the incident.
So let me just boil it down. She was a 22-year-old woman alone in New York. No one is with her. Her entire contacts, flight arrangements, Wi-Fi, emails, Apple Pay, her funds, her money is all on that phone. She agreed that her behavior and her actions were definitely less than elegant, shall we say, and less than graceful,
yeah,
and
yeah,
less than what anyone else would do. And she agreed, and she wouldn't have repeated it.
It's been reported that your phone was returned to you by an Uber driver. Is that true?
That is not true, because I arrived at the hotel with my phone in my hand.
Okay, who returned your phone to you?
The hotel receptionist.
Mia, where had the phone been?
Why don't we ask the hotel receptionist?
Mia, to be honest, I'm telling you, you seem to be not remorseful, to have no contrition, that you're almost a little flippant about this. You have to understand, for this teenage boy who says that he was shattered, who said that he was traumatized, this
I'm
is a big
traumatized.
Deal. You're traumatized too, because...
Yeah, and I'm sorry. I'm sorry from the bottom of my heart. He is honestly, he's 14. That's what they're claiming. I'm 22. I've lived probably just the same amount of life as him. Like, honestly, I'm just as a kid at heart as he is. I feel sorry that I made the family go through like all of that stress, but at the same time, it wasn't just them going through that.
I just don't think that you helped yourself by your behavior.
Of course not. When you looked
at that video, what did you think? What did you think, Mia, when you looked at the video?
You already asked me that in the beginning of the interview. I'm not going over it again. I would like to have a real interview with real questions and real heart and real sincere apologies. Let 2021 be the moment of healing. Seriously.
All right. What would you want an interview with real questions? I'll give you the floor. What would you like us to know, Mia?
That I'm sincerely sorry to the family, and the dad and the son for making them feel as if I was racist towards them when that is not my intention.
Now, during the interview, Ponsetto kept interrupting her attorney, and Sharon Gatan says her client went off script. According to her lawyer, Ponsetto was prepared for this interview. They had talked about it. They had gone over it. But the 22-year-old, she says, decided to disregard her advice she was given and just went on her own. Mia Ponsetto was due back in court in March. I really felt for the attorney. We cut out a lot of it because I think you already get a sense of Mia Ponsetto. But there was a very interesting exchange between the attorney and Mia at one point, and we just decided just to let it go. But the attorney says, look, she's concerned about her mental health and her well-being, and she, of course, wishes her well. And I could see why she is concerned. The attorney worked very, very hard to try to guide her client during the interview, and it just, you know, I think it's hard when you have a client that doesn't pay attention to what you're saying. Yeah, I think that's very difficult.
It's difficult to sit there in silence while your client essentially gets herself in trouble. And judging by the backlash over the weekend to the first part of your interview, it was not received well.
Yeah, I'm not sure if Mia really understands the gravity of this situation yet. I'm still not convinced.
Once she was arrested, I think she probably figured that out.
But we're in the keep shoveling. Yeah. The holes get.